season in 4 final rounds. It's his 18th national event win and 38 final round appearances. Did it all with a borrowed car. We'll talk about that in just a bit. And Jason, there are a lot of wins that are big for you, but obviously to come to the Summit race at the Summit Motorsports Park, it's got to be one of the best wins for you.
This is absolutely the biggest win for me, and it was a great time to do it. You know, we're tired of watching that yellow car win races, and we need to get our share too, and just haven't done a good job lately. But we're starting to right the ship, and by any time we're gonna be strong, and hopefully this is a sign of things to come for us. And it was a great day, and I just can't thank everybody at Summit enough. And Summit Motorsports Park did a great job making the best out of the racetrack, and just hats off to them for going to the extra effort.
Tell us about the thought process behind changing the race car. From a fan point of view, it looked like your other race car was doing pretty well.
Well, my truck driver, Sonny McCurdy, he told me a couple weeks ago, he said, keep doing what you're doing, you'll keep getting what you're getting. And so he said, you know, we got to change something up here, because we've just been terrible. And, we're a better team than that. And so we had to do something. So we decided to, and actually it was Rob's decision, and hats off to him for deciding to make a change, it was time, and there's really nothing wrong with the other car. It just, we were just kind of, we couldn't see the forest for the trees, so made some changes, and obviously it's paying off for us, and it's going to get better.
Now, what's your game plan now? Will you stay with this car? You've got a week off before you begin the Western swing. What car will you take on the road with you?
I think we'd be pretty foolish to get off this winning horse, so we're definitely, they're going to have to pry my hands off of it, so we're gonna just keep racing this car.
Questions for Jason?
In addition to changing cars, I believe you all also tested up in Michigan as well. How important was that test to today?
We did. We tested up in Martin, and those guys did a great job for us up there, and they were good to work with. And we learned a lot, actually, and it was conditions similar to this in a lot of ways. So it was good for us, and I would say it's probably one of the most productive test sessions we've had. And it's not just going to help us now, but 2 months from now, it's going to help us even more.
When you guys go in test sessions, you don't normally take both cars. What cars did you take, and which car did you test?
We took the two cars that we raced this weekend, and both of them ran about like they did up there. So we still don't have enough for Edwards yet, but we're working on it. He's causing my wife and kids not to see me as much as they want to, but it's going to pay off for us down the road.
You don't normally have many rounds when a driver will say, "I'm looking forward to running the Big E later." You did that before Mike Edwards' semifinal. Did you hear anything about that from Greg Stanfield?
I did not, actually, and I certainly didn't mean any disrespect for him, because he's as good of a driver as anybody out here. And he's probably better than, he might be the best driver out here. I don't know. He's certainly a great driver, and didn't mean any disrespect for him, but just Edwards is so tough that really for anybody to beat him, I think, is a pretty big feat.
And you talked about, Jags and him winning and everything, but Edwards had been really strong. Did you look at any of those past wins where Jags has beat him and said, this is where I might could get him at?
Not really. My plan was to snap the clutch out as fast as possible, and I felt like if I really nailed it, I could beat Tina. It wasn't as good today as I would like to be on the tree, but I was reasonably steady, and that for me, I was good. But felt like if we get a couple hundreds on him, we could, we had a shot to beat him. And unfortunately for him, he had some issues in the final there. But and we made it actually a pretty darn good run. So for us to make that kind of run in the final was a big deal also, because we've struggled with final rounds, especially in the last year or two. So I think the boys learned a little something, and I hope it's a sign of things to come.
Other questions?
So is the win going to make it easier for your family to see you, or is it going to make it more difficult?
It's not going to be any easier, but they are coming with me on the Western swing, and that time is a hard time of year for those of us that are engine builders and work on developing horsepower, because we're gone. It's the biggest time of year for the race season to really get in the way of engine development. So there's not going to be a lot going on during those 3 weeks, but. I am going to get to spend some time with my family, and I'm very excited about that.
Jason, with the last 2 years, in the Pro Stock division, the last 2 years, Summit has won, and in the first year, the inaugural, Dave Connolly, who is his hometown, won. Is there a possible thing as like an emotional boost from a certain racetrack?
I think so. I think that it's one of those things where if you think about everything, you think about something so much that all your thoughts, everything kind of gravitates you in that direction. And, you know, I think somehow you find a way to will yourself to a win. And maybe that's what happens today. So, I don't know, it was a great day for us. And, you know, I said yesterday we were going to win the race. And saying that without having the best car is maybe a little bit of a bold statement. But, you know, like I said, the yellow car does it all the time. So why can't we?
Thank you very much, Jason Lyon.